never saw that. Let me go there.
How are you today?
I'm gonna walk her.
Thank you. the next stop that we went
to. We were on par earlier.
Patrick and Jessica would like to pause for a moment to remember those who can't be present here today and those who are no longer with us. Now as we begin, Patrick and Jessica would like to take a moment to especially thank and recognize their parents. These are special people who helped raise them into the adult persons they've become today. They've given Patrick and Jessica each an excellent example of marriage that they'll try and emulate in their own marriage. Her parents have been married 34 years and his 41 years. They've equipped and embraced Patrick and Jessica towards their hopes and dreams, and welcome their new spouse into their hearts, their homes, and their lives. As Patrick and Jessica begin this next chapter of their lives together, they'd like to simply pause and say thank you. We gather as a community of family and friends and feel ripples of excitement and tremors of joy as we celebrate the marriage of Patrick and Jessica. The world is filled with harmony. Soaring birds, towering trees, brisk wind, animals of all kinds, each unique, each in relationship and harmony with the others. Patrick and Jessica have come here to affirm their love for each other and enter into this beautiful tapestry of life. Marriage is a gift. Marriage is an opportunity for love to be learned. Marriage is a journey in which we as the travelers are faced with many choices and are responsible for these choices. Marriage is a call to servanthood. Marriage is a call to friendship. Marriage is a call to suffering. Marriage is not an event, but a way of life. Marriage involves intimacy in all areas for it to be fulfilling. Today, Patrick and Jessica, you come together bringing all of you to this marriage, all of your wonderful parts, all of your hurts and pains. You especially bring today all of your hopes and dreams for this marriage. In our conversation together, Jessica, Patrick shared that I knew you were the one for me because after dating for a year, we broke up. We still kept talking and went on a cruise for a friend's wedding that had been planned before we broke up, and the fire was rekindled. After that, I had realized you are the one. I'd never ever stopped thinking about you and couldn't actually stop thinking about you. You're perfect for me because you're very caring and always make sure that I'm always happy in this relationship. And Patrick, Jessica shared that I knew you're the one for me when I saw you holding our daughter. You're perfect for me because when I'm anxious, you keep me grounded. You're kind and you don't try to change people. You both have tremendous faith in each other as you trust your future to the other's care, and you have excellent reasons for believing you belong together, but you have no guarantees. Instead, you stand together about to accept on faith the challenge of creating the future together. You promise to be faithful to one another in big things as well as small, and your constant faith in each other will give form and substance to the beautiful hopes you have for your future. Unless you're an unusual couple, at times your marriage won't look anything like the vision you celebrate today. You may not feel much evidence of the love you now feel so keenly. At such a time, remember this moment. Remember the hopes and dreams that have been entrusted to your care. Marriage begins with a leap of faith that says, I will, before an unknown and unknowable future. Marriage is about being full of faith or faithful to one another. Faithfulness respects each other's ideas and feelings, keeps each other's secrets, guards each other's dignity, and honors each other in public and in private. Faithfulness is built from 10,000 minute acts of trust and trustworthiness. In such faith, you'll find the fulfillment of all the hopes and dreams you have today. Patrick and Jessica, have you come here freely without reservation to join together lawfully in marriage? If so, say, I have. Before family and friends, I ask you to affirm your vows to each other. As you enter into this marriage, begin to share all the joys of this new relationship, whatever the future may hold.
Jessica, I can remember the day we met like it was yesterday. You are kind and caring and are such a wonderful mother to show. I love you so much and I'm so excited to be here with you today. I promise to be loving and patient. Even when you throw your clothes on the kitchen floor. I'll be the very, very best husband to you. And the very, very best father to Charlotte. We will hopefully travel to all 50 states together because I know that's something that you want to do, but no promises. I will love you in good times and bad for as long as we both shall live.
When we first met, I knew there was something different about you. You weren't looking for someone who could be you. You weren't looking for a missing piece or your other half. You were already a whole person. I, on the other hand, was a very broken person. I was unsure of who I was or what I wanted. And so
rings are an outward invisible sign of an invisible truth which binds two hearts in one. As such, they're the symbols of the enduring and unending quality of the love which is now expressed between Patrick and Jessica. Patrick, repeat after me. Jessica.
Jessica.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed. Jessica, repeat after me. Patrick. With this ring. I thee wed. May you take on the world together with all your hopes and dreams. May you be each other's anchor in smoother rocky seas. May you bend to the world's winds and brave stalls and storms. May you find common ground in all its changing forms. May you cross stubborn boundaries and turn many a stone. May you find haven for your souls. May you have heart and home. And if some days are gray and some nights are long and cold, may you be each other's sun and moon as your destinies unfold. And should you lose sight of each other and start to drift apart, may you circle back by following the compass of your hearts. Patrick and Jessica, in the future, happy occasions will come as surely as the morning. Difficult times will come as surely as the night. To say the words love and compassion is easy, but to accept that love and compassion are built upon patience and perseverance is not easy. Patrick and Jessica, as much as you've declared your willingness to enter the state of marriage with each other, and declare the same in the company of these witnesses, by the virtue of authority vested in me by the state of Florida, I pronounce you husband and wife. It's my pleasure to introduce to you all for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Patrick and Jessica DeGrama. Patrick, thank you. Taking some pictures of this time, so immediate family, please take close group photos. Everybody else, we got an amazing setup over here for drinks and reception. Okay, thank you all for being here.
Put him back on the card.